Okay, so at my day job, we have about 3 or 4 acres of land, and in the back there is a series of containers, some grassy areas, a chain link fence. On the other side of the chain link fence, there's a wooded area, and along the other side of that fence, there's a wooded area, but then there's immediately a neighborhood. Well, we tend to have quite a few varmint come out of those wooded areas. And currently, we've got feral cats and raccoons. Well, it's technically illegal to feed raccoons because they're wild animals. Feral cats, it's maybe a gray area. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna build what I'm dubbing a cat condominium, which is essentially a cat house with a hole big enough for cats to get through, but the raccoons with their fat bellies can't quite fit. So we want to build a stilted structure. So maybe about 6 to 8 inches off the ground. It really doesn't matter the height. And it's going to be lean-to style, so the roof will be angled sort of like that. And then on the front, we're going to put like a little porch sort of platform so the cats can kind of jump up there and then wiggle their way through the hole. And then the roof will be hinged. So if the animal-loving, bleeding-heart people I work with want to feed the cats, they can lift the lid, aka the roof, and put a bowl of cat food down inside there, and then we'll add some straw and then maybe some LED fairy lights just to make it magical. All right, so I got a whole bunch of pallet material. We're gonna start with that. We'll start breaking down some of that, knocking some nails out, and then honestly, gonna figure out all the measurements as I go. Don't want to overthink this because if I overthink it, it becomes less fun. Okay, so when I said earlier that this would all be fun, maybe I misspoke. This is taking quite a while. Thank you.
Okay, I just used this straight edge and these two clamps to establish my roof pitch. And I'll do the same over on the other side, and then we'll use a circular saw and cut that off. So what we'll be doing is we'll be cutting some plywood, one for the floor, and then we'll do the walls in plywood. Actually, we're gonna save the front for later because I'm going to do something different, but these two sides, this back panel will be cut from plywood, probably OSB, and the floor will be just regular plywood. And then we're gonna actually clad the outside with pallet slats, and that's going to be basically the shingling. So anyway, let's get moving. Okay, I came in today about noon and started working on this and didn't even think to hit record. So we've got our walls all closed in, and we actually have a little cat hole right here, and put some cladding on the front, and we just gotta start doing the sides, and then we'll start to fit the roof panel, which of course is going to be hinged. So that's our next task, and we're gonna jump into that after I finish my lunch. Thank you.
Okay, so here is our progress so far. I kind of did a lot of work, like off camera, like I always do. But we've got all the walls covered in cladding, and we've got our porch here, and we've got a little cover over the roof, which I'm hoping will kind of deter the raccoons from wiggling in here. Who knows if that'll actually work. And we've got the roof on and it's hinged. And all we're going to do is we'll add a hook and eye latch right here, just so that the critters don't try to open it themselves. Which, I don't think that the raccoons can do that, but you just never know. Back here with the cat condo, it's in position, and I'm just gonna scatter some food inside of it and try and draw them in. But yeah, as far as I'm concerned, it's open for business, so hopefully they use it and hopefully the raccoons can't get into it, but time will tell. Here's their kibble. So we'll put this in the top, maybe scatter this around the floor in the bottom near the opening, the doorway, and hopefully that'll draw them in. That's all she wrote. I will take you in for a closer look. All right, so you see I've kind of scattered it all around in there. There's the bowl, little bits of kibble all inside. So yeah, my job here is done. Boom.